ahead and get started. Obviously, we're here for the SOAR Awards. You know that me, I'm Amy Haley, I'm the chair of the county commission. Y'all know thank you so much for being here today, and we are really excited to have the opportunity to honor some of you all for the hard work that you do, and we're so grateful for everything you do for the citizens of our county. So, and there's Bruce.
We're here to help read. If you won't help read, or you can...
Okay, well, yeah, I'll start with the first one, and we'll just rotate through. The first person being honored is Jamona Llewellyn. Did I say that right? Okay, come on up. And the deal is we have your picture taken. Everything. So Jamona is a very hardworking, dedicated employee. Jamona has helped me and so many others. Oh, and she's with the social services. She's helped me and so many others in our office with questions that we may need help with on cases, especially when it comes to the financial part of child support cases. Jamona is a good person who encourages me on a daily basis. She is a person that goes above and beyond and will help anyone without any questions asked. I'm so thankful for my coworker and my friend, Jamona Llewellyn.
County Department of Social Services, and this particular nomination was submitted by a customer, so by someone from the public. Says, please come on up. I would like to recognize Kara Brothers. Thanks for going the extra mile in order to assist me through the daycare process. Kara was very understanding and found the answers to my many questions. I know her work schedule is heavy. I thank her for not treating my daughter and I like a number, instead a citizen of this great community. Kara was patient and kind. I'll never forget her. Thank you very much.
January 11th, the department sent a last-minute print shop request with a deadline for 5 p.m. Robert kindly rearranged his schedule to complete the job. Further, there was an additional job that had to be completed by the following Monday afternoon, with the threat of ice and a chance that county government could be delayed. Robert got permission to come in Saturday morning to finish so that it would be ready on time. This is clear above expectations of his position. We appreciate his willingness to come work on a Saturday.
Thank you.
Inconsolable. The staff stated that this had happened before and that the patient had a history of being combative when help had arrived. She was very concerned about anyone coming near her and was obviously in pain. The patient began to scream hysterically, but Paul kneeled down, held her hand, and explained what he was going to do and calmed the patient down before obtaining a very difficult intravenous access and administered pain medication that allowed EMS to safely splint the patient's hand, transfer her to the EMS stretcher, and transport her safely to Alamance Regional. The patient was obviously calmed by Paul's presence, and what he was able to get accomplished with that patient was remarkable. As a new paramedic myself, Paul is an excellent paramedic to emulate how he interacts with patients and how he performs his skills. Per the staff at Alamance House, they said, nominate him for some kind of award. And I was happy to do so on their behalf.
Yeah.
next nominee is Edwina DeRosa from the Libraries, Alamance County Passport Program Manager. Come on up, Edwina.
She may be the all-time story.
Gosh, I'm Yes. So the nomination reads, Edwina was very courteous and saw us the same day for my daughter's passport. She said that it may take up to 4 weeks for it to come in, and it came in 20 days. She really looks after her clients and makes sure that you get everything done in one trip by giving you all that you need over the phone before coming to the office. She is an asset to this department.
Thank you. In disagreement about something. Amanda stepped in very quickly. Sure, more of that story, right? Amanda stepped in very quickly and defeated the situation between the two patrons that were on the verge of fighting. She was professional and courteous. She went above and beyond with a very difficult patient.
Ms. Sharp and Ms. Lindsay listened to my needs and were able to reserve and provide my event with the supplies we needed without any problem. They were even able to accommodate last-minute requests for mice and did so, as they always do, with a pleasant professional attitude. While they could be said to just be doing their job, I believe their positive outlook and friendly demeanor should qualify them as nominees for our SOAR Employee Award.
So next nominee is Mark Dockery of the Alamance County Sheriff's Department.
Mark, I want to make a note, Brian, I hate
you. So Mark recently created a software program that streams their radio channel, allowing multiple users with a link to access radio traffic. This feature runs over $6,000, and Mark was able to do it for $120. More importantly, this allows greater connectivity and communication between emergency services personnel. Mark felt that it was an important added feature that would benefit emergency services departments. His innovation and creativity should be recognized.
Stand up, Mark.
Again, this came from a customer. Really, really good. This customer stated, just want to thank you for helping with your time and knowledge. Dealing with the public can be difficult and seemingly thankless profession. I would not have known which way to turn or where to get my meals. I was never made to feel less human. I was treated with dignity.
As you know, many times we hear when things do not go quite right. but rarely do we hear when things do go right. That's why I'm dropping you a note. During this budget process, I've had many questions asked of Susan Evans by phone or email. Every time, Susan has answered each question both quickly and graciously. She even came to Elaine's office to help us enter the budget information, even though she was on her way to an appointment and it was the end of the day. I cannot express adequately the gratitude I have for Susan and the work she is doing.
I too have many budget questions. Three different nominees. And these are all from Alamance County EMS, and I hope I say the names correctly. Patricia Claggett, Tracy Gould, and Lauren Olitsky.
They did tell me they were
wearing this uniform. So on Tuesday, the 19th of February, 2019, I required emergency medical services. Three of your employees responded, rendered aid, and gave me a ride to the hospital. Due to my weakened condition, they had to navigate my 200 pounds through narrow doorways and downstairs. They took appropriate care with the needle sticks they had to perform. My blood pressure was very low, and the needle insertion was not an easy task. They maintained an appropriate level of professionalism during the entire experience and managed to make me not worry about my condition. The entire time, I felt as if they actually cared about my condition. I never once felt that I was just a job, end quote. I think that later in the day, in my bed at the ER, one of them looked in the door to my room to see how I was doing. While I sincerely hope that I would not need EMS service again, I would be pleased to see any of these professionals show up to assist me if ever I did need EMS. Please let them know that they are appreciated. These are the kind of employees that Alamance County EMS should hold on to.
Patrons need additional help with the setup of her e-books and e-audiobooks. She went above and beyond to delete her personal e-audiobook apps and reinstall so she was able to assist patrons. Shannon is pleasant to work with and has established a rewarding relationship with several patrons. She is committed to the library patrons at any branch and often spends additional time to ensure each patron needs are met. County Social Services. Kelly is the only fraud investigator for Alamance County DSS. In her role, she is responsible for investigating all referrals made to the agency by co-workers, state agencies, and the general public, which is a huge task. She is professional, diligent, courteous, and knows what she is doing. Her success rate in identifying and collecting overpayments is amazing. To say her job is thankless is an understatement. Some of the people she meets with are less than pleasant. She is always courteous, always. I think Kelly is deserving of a SOAR award.
All right, and award, and that goes to Kim Jones from DSS. Kim received three separate nominations from the public during this quarter. First one, she went out of her way time and time again for me. She really cares. Second, my nominee was respectful, attentive, courteous, professional, and knowledgeable. She listened to my need and concerns. She's the best. And then finally, Kimberly Jones is the true example of teamwork. On this particular occasion, Ms. Jones was the only agent physically available in her department. Another agent had a non-custodial parent located out of state called from the airport, unable to board a plane to tend to the passing of his grandmother due to a passport denial. Kim went above and beyond to research the issue, even though it was outside of her expertise, to contact the other state to verify the non-custodial parent was no longer in arrears, submit the proper paperwork to Raleigh, and kept in contact with the non-custodial parent until the matter was resolved. I'm sure this made an already difficult situation a bit easier for the parent, which would not have happened without Ms. Jones' initiative. Wow. Accomplishments. It's a real honor to me to be allowed to take part in this role. And we have some refreshments over there. If you care for some, do you want to say?
It's just always refreshing to be able to come to these awards and hear these great stories, because you don't always get to hear all the great things y'all are doing. And I certainly appreciate it. It's an honor to be able to serve with you. So thank you for what you do.
Yeah, thank you very much.